There is Austin Haynes back in the starting lineup, but back in the lineup after missing the VMI game, but could not win it back Delaware's way as Villanova was closer to the ball as it went out of bounds. So Delaware dodges a bullet there as the pipe saves the early goal. Villanova still with the ball. Cuccinella now gets it up top to Fracaro. Down low, coming past goal line extended, trying to get inside around John O'Connor, but it's not there. A turnover. But the ball is picked up once again by Fracaro. Averaging over 4.5 goals per game. Set a Villanova record with 8 goals against Penn State. He also holds the record for most goals in a game at Princeton, where he played in 2014 when he had 10. There's a shot right off the chest of Parker Farragan. So the ball's on the ground. Delaware needs to get this ground ball. Still bouncing around. Now it's up, and it goes back into a Nova stick once again. That's John Clue. So a long possession. Look inside. That one is missed. Rolling back towards the midline. If it goes over, it is a turnover. But Fracaro is there to pick it up. Now along to the right side. We get a dodge. Clue behind. Gets above goal line extended and drops it in. That was Christian Cuccinello, actually the sophomore from Mountain Lakes, New Jersey, getting the scoring started for Nova. For Cuccinello, that is his 9th goal of the season, 2nd on the team, only to Fracaro, who has 14. So in that first possession, Nova was able to get off 3 shots. The ball was on the ground multiple times. Delaware unable to come up with the ground ball. And we are back to the faceoff X. It'll be Walsh and Owen Hughes, it looks like. That is Palmadesso again. Didn't see the 2 in front of the 3 there. The ball's rolling towards Delaware's offensive end, but it's once again scooped up by Nova. That is John Madursky picking it up and getting it to the near side for Danny Sweeney, who will look to clear. And we have a player down. That's Tim Lyons in the middle of the field, the senior. And he looks like he's in a bit of pain, but is able to get back up onto his feet. That would be a tough loss for the Hens, but it looks like he's just got a stinger and he'll walk it off. It's cold down there, so every stick, every check on any part of your body hurts a little bit extra today. We'll definitely hope to see Tim Lyons. Excuse me, that's number 18, Tommy Jovin. My mistake. The junior from Easton, Maryland. Villanova able to get it over the midfield line. That's Matt McIver. Now to the near side. Ball goes back up top to Joey Fracaro. Slide comes. Some heavy checks being thrown. Fracaro still with it. Fakes the pass. Lefty shot. That one goes wide. The backup is there for Nova. Joey Fracaro, the freshman, the younger brother of Jake Fracaro. Now we get a dodge on the right side. That's Devin McNamara. Now the ball goes to X. Cuccinello gets above goal line extended with his right hand. Spins back left. Looking inside, has 2 Delaware defenders hung up. Now John O'Connor has to retreat and find the open man. Now Jake Fracaro with it. He has it at X. Spins back to his right, working on Connor Lally. There's a rip. That one misses wide right. The try there from Joey Fracaro. Nova still with possession. McNamara. Has it again. Slide has to come. Ducks inside. Takes the shot. That one misses. Cuccinello's there for the backup. Looks top right for Caro. Trying to get around John O'Connor, and John O'Connor's able to get a stick to the shot, and the shot actually took John O'Connor's stick with it. And there's another rip. That one goes high. That shot from Danny Seibel. For Caro. Works it to his brother. 55 and 54, making it extra confusing for the broadcasters this afternoon. Here's Jake Vaccaro. He gets it back. John O'Connor on him. Looks down low. Good find. Cuccinello spins back left. Draws the slide. Excuse me. It looks like Delaware playing a little bit of a zone down low. Quick slide comes. O'Connor works in. That's a void and a beautiful shot there from Danny Seibel. Avoids the check. Keeps his stick low and then rifles it into the top right corner. Wildcats up 2-0. That is his third goal of the season. We see it again there. Beautiful job avoiding the check and then keeps his stick low and gets a tremendous amount of power on it for how little he cocked it back and knocks it into the top right. So once again, it'll be Walsh and Pomodesso. Back to take the face. On the near side, we have Jack Coran, as well as Anthony Sebastiani. Walsh won the clamp, and he pops it out to himself. Really nice job. And let's see if Delaware can answer now. Isel with it. Now Romagnoli getting his first touch. Delaware getting their first line of middies on the field. Connor Frasina, Steve DeLargy, and Nick DeSanzo. DeLargy, and that ball sails past DeLargy's stick, rolling towards the midline. DeLargy's able to scoop it up. Looks like we have an offsides call there against the Blue Hens. Little miscommunication there in the substitution. There's a shot between the legs of Farragut, and it's in. Devin McNamara capitalizing on the mistake there from the Blue Hens. Assist coming from Owen Hughes. McNamara's seventh goal of the season. And just like that, we are back to the faceoff X. Looks like Walsh won the clamp again. And he flips it up to himself beautifully. So two straight face-off wins for the junior from Mountain Lakes, New Jersey. Now Delaware will look to get a settled offensive possession. Romagnoli. Now for Delaware's offense. You want to see them work together as a team, not let one person try to do too much. That's what the tendency might be after getting in an early hole. But trust the system, try to ride the offensive momentum from VMI. Delaware putting in a season-high 14 goals. Major gets topside. Now rolls back to his right. Here's Connor Frasina. Lightning quick midi. Goes to his right. Looks cross crease. The man was there, but the pass a little low for Steve DeLargy, who had a beautiful backdoor cut. And now the middies will get off. And the defensive midfielders will hop in for the Hens. John Madursky with it. Villanova able to clear once again. Now the ball works behind. There's McNamara. Ball comes up top to Vaccaro. Nova finishes their substitutions. That'll be Clue. Dodging on Elijah Conti. Splits back left. Gains some separation. McNamara takes a top side. Gets a double screen. Works it down low. Now to X. Cuccinello to the near side for Clue. Clue gets just enough room. Unleashes a rocket that sails over the top of the cage. John Clue only 5'4", 140. But man, he gets some power behind that shot. Cuccinello gets topside. Lions trailing there with the double team. Slide comes, Villanova reverses it. Coran. For Caro, back to Coran, has some room, lefty shot, picks the top right corner. The senior captain from Fairhaven, New Jersey, working there with Jake Fracaro. Just absolutely rips open the top shelf of the cage, and the University of Delaware will call a timeout. We'll take another look at it here. Fracaro garners so much respect from the defense. And Coran just switches it to his left hand, and before the slide could get there, buries the shot. And we're not even 7 minutes into this game, and Villanova with a 4-0 lead over the Blue Hens. This is a Villanova team averaging 15 goals a game. They opened the season with a heartbreaking overtime loss to number 17, Harvard. Then they took on Penn State when they were ranked 15th in the nation at Penn State and beat them 19-9. Then they just had a win over Delaware CAA rival Drexel 14-9. And you would think if the score was if you told me the score would be this the score would be at where it is right now this early in the game, I would have said that Paul Modesto was just kept getting Villanova possessions via the faceoff, but that actually hasn't been the case. Each team has won two. Sam Walsh has won the last two right off the clamp. So he's been winning the clamp and then been able to pop it into his stick immediately and given Delaware offensive chances. And apart from one of their goals, Villanova have not really had... The chances haven't been super wide open. There hasn't been many miscommunications there defensively. They just been the shot release has been so quick for the Wildcats offensively, and they just been burying their shots. So Delaware now electing to double pull the wing, putting John O'Connor down on the defensive end. It'll be Austin Haynes as well as Anthony Sebastiani on the wing. Walsh and Paul Modesto ready to go at it again. Delaware down 4-0. Looks like we have a face-off violation there against Walsh, so Villanova will get the ball back again. For Caro. Cuccinello behind. Working on John O'Connor. Cuccinello to his right, gets topside. Looking to feed inside, gets to Fracaro. This is Joey Fracaro on the dodge. Slides past one defender, now gets it down low. Fracaro thought about the shot, now looks inside, and that one's knocked down. Fracaro ends up getting it again and misses the shot wide right. Here's Devin McNamara from X. Dodges to his right, looks inside, there's the feed, the shot and the goal! Goal coming from number 34, Matt McIver, the senior from Andover, Massachusetts, with a great cut down the middle of the field. Devin McNamara found him. And is now 5-0 Wildcats. Delaware wasting no time getting the ball back to the middle of the field. Take another look at it here. And that's what you want, the off-ball movement. Delaware in a little bit of a hole here early. In need of a good offensive possession, give their defense a rest. Walsh and Palmadesso. Looks like Walsh has won the clamp again, but the ball's still in the middle of the field. Hayes trying to pick up the ground ball. Sebastiani's kicking it around. The ball is yet to be possessed, so, and now it has, so the attack and the D can release. Hayes got the ground ball, but then was hounded by two Wildcats. John O'Connor comes up with it. He loses it. Now Fracaro comes up with it, but he can't quite handle it. And now he gets dispossessed by John O'Connor, and finally it is settled by the Wildcats. The sun peeking out from behind the clouds. Still none of the sun benefiting the fans here at University of Delaware. We're still in the shade. Cuccinello at X. Gets to the near side, now up top. Fracaro. Looks to the far side. There's a rip. That one pings off the crossbar from Jack Curran. The ball goes out of play. Villanova will maintain possession. John Clue. It's behind. Villanova in the 1-3-2 from behind. And now they go into an open set. Clue. Cuccinello gets it up top. There's a rip from Fracaro, and that one misses wide left. Villanova getting long offensive possessions. Delaware's barely had the ball on offense this quarter. Curran leaves it back for Clue. Now back to Curran. Gets it up top. Look inside. There's the shot. Misses wide. And the ball movement from Nova has been lightning quick. It almost looks like they're on man up when they're even. Clue gets top side. Takes the shot, and that one sails out of his stick. Not sure if Conti or Hayes were able to get a check on it. But once again, Nova's there with the backup. Cuccinello. Working on Carson Scott. Now up top for Cerrone. There's the look. Cerrone tried to quick stick it in. Maybe that was Curran. Cerrone comes up and gets the ground ball, avoiding a monster check from Connor Lally. Look inside is not there. It's rolling towards the midfield line. Fracaro able to one-hand scoop it. Now look backside. Cuccinello tries to go topside. Carson Scott in good position. Now there's the roll. The shot, and it's in. Another one from Christian Cuccinello. Beat Carson Scott topside, kept his feet moving, and buried it. It is now 6-0 Wildcats. Take another look at it here. The adjacent slide could not quite get there in time. And Cuccinello buried it. 6-0 Villanova with 5 minutes left to go in the first quarter. Delaware's only had two offensive possessions. Palmadesso won the clamp, but coming in to disrupt it was Matt Ulbrich, and then we're going to get a push from behind on Villanova. It's a good job there by the sophomore from Morristown to come and earn Delaware an offensive possession. Paul Major spins back left. Looking up top to Fresina, now to Largie. The first offensive line of middies for the Hens. They've had a nice rest. DeSanzo with some room, takes the shot, it's knocked down. Now it's rolling towards the end line and goes out of play. Last touch by DeSanzo. DeSanzo with a nice lefty dodge. He had the room, but a good slide from Fernando Delgado. Just knocked the ball down, and now Nova will look to clear. They get it over the midfield line with relative ease. TJ Camizio, the freshman from Basking Ridge, New Jersey. Here's Joey Fracaro. Working on Elijah Conti. Gets topside. Looks inside. Now goes down low. The ball's knocked down, but picked up by Jake Fracaro. Now the ball's up top. Joey Fracaro goes to his left, has some room, gets inside, takes the shot. That one misses wide left. Backup is there for Villanova. Devin McNamara. Two-man game with Cuccinello. That pass is awry, but the attackman able to pick it up. Jake Fracaro has a screen to his right, decides to use it. Good switch there from Delaware. Fracaro on Conti. Spins back to his right. Conti is there. Spins back to his left, looks to take a shot, and it looks like Farragan got a piece of that one and directed it wide of the cage. But another long possession for Villanova where they've gotten multiple chances at goal. Cuccinello. There's a shot. That one goes wide of the cage from Devin McNamara. Thought he might have stepped in the crease there, but I guess was able to tiptoe around it. Cuccinello. Joey Ficarro with the dodge. Spins back left. The slide comes. Looks far side. There's a lefty shot. Rip. Top shelf from number six, Danny Seibel, with his second goal of the afternoon. Joey Ficarro with the assist. His second assist of the year. And for Seibel, that is now his fourth goal of the season. And it is 7-0 Wildcats. And we are not out of the first quarter. Palmadesso wins the clamp, scoops it to himself. And Villanova with another possession. There's Dan Willis. His only test so far in this game has been trotting it up the field and helping on the clears. Villanova able to clear once again. Coran. Works it over to the right. Clue. We know he can rip it. He decides to work it behind. Cuccinello. Tries to get topside on John O'Connor. O'Connor in good position. Now the slide comes. Coran draws a double team, spins out of it. Ficarro looking to feed. Has John O'Connor. Ficarro gets topside, one-hand shot. I guess when you're up by seven, you can try some tricky stuff like that. And now we will get a timeout from the University of Delaware, who find themselves down by seven with 1 minute and 54 seconds left to go in the first half. See what adjustments can be made by Delaware, who need a defensive stop and then have to try to get in at least one goal here before the end of the first quarter, try to build some momentum and get back in this game. We're going to step aside for just a moment. We'll be right back with more lacrosse here on Hens All Access. Kyle Coulter back with you here at University of Delaware Stadium. Villanova once again with the ball on offense. With a minute and 45 remaining, there's a backdoor cut. The shot, and it's in! The goal from Devin McNamara puts Villanova up 8-0. McNamara with his second goal of the afternoon. And Harry Delaferra, senior attackman from Locust Valley, New York, with the assist. His second assist of the season. We are back at the faceoff X. Delaware now going with a single pull on the wing for the faceoff. Jake Herveda trying his luck against Palmadesa. It is won again by the Wildcats. Vaquero with it on the near side. Tries to get topside on Connor Lally. Now passes it across field. Devin McNamara gets it back to McIver, who's got a goal on the day. He's defended by Anthony Sebastiani. McIver takes it above goal line, extended, now gets it up top. Delaware still subbing through the midfield line. They're man down. Look backside, Cuccinello. Looking to feed. Cannot find a man, so he decides to take it up top. Vaquero with under a minute to go in the first quarter. He's got John O'Connor on defense. Splits to his left, draws a slide, moves it. Second line of middies on the field for Nova. 30 seconds. Jake Vaquero with Matt Olbrich on him. Looks like he's going to walk it out, much like a point guard at the end of a quarter. An attack with about 10 left. And at exactly 10, he goes. Vaquero draws a slide, moves it. That one found its way to De La Fera. 2 seconds, De La Fera loses it. Has to try to put up a shot, but he will not be able to. So Delaware holds on Villanova's last possession. That was about the only possession they did. Villanova jumps out to an 8-0 lead after the first 15 minutes over the University of Delaware. A host of goal scorers for the Cats. McNamara with two, Cuccinello with two, Coran with one, Saibo with two, and McIver with one. On the other side, there's only been one shot for the Hens, and that has been Anthony DeSanzo with a shot on a lefty dodge. He had plenty of room. But it was a great slide, and the ball was knocked down. Nova with five face-off wins, Delaware with four. Parker Farragan has faced a firing squad in cage in the first quarter. 8 goals allowed. He's made 2 saves. So as the two teams talk it over in their huddles, we will step aside. We'll be right back with the start of the second quarter here on Hens All Access.
Congratulations to our trivia winner at TomCat33. Please come up to the press box to claim your prize.
Certainly not the start the University of Delaware had envisioned, going into the second quarter down by 8. Still plenty of time left in this game. You're going to need to get a more longer offensive possessions, I should say, and try to get better quality shots. To take the faceoff, it will be Brent Kuhnquist for Villanova and Jake Herveda for Delaware. I'm going to say Kuhnquist was laying on it. So Delaware will get the first offensive possession of the second quarter. Second line of middies on the field now for the Hens. Trooper Ortlieb with it. They're going to go inverted middie. He takes his man behind. Going to do a two-man game with Chris Culinary. Culinary backs out, looks to reattack. Goes to his right. Still going, trying to get topside. Paul Major Now the ball's up top with Dean DeSimone. Major. Moves over to Easel. Both middies behind the cage for the Hens. Might make it tough for them to recover if there's a turnover. Levine. Calling Eric, excuse me. Major. Has it up top. Spins, gets it to Romagnoli. DeSimone. Gets it behind to Culinary. He gets a screen. Culinary with it again. He dodges to his left. Spins back right, looking to feed. Fakes the pass, goes inside, draws the double team, now moves it up top to DeSimone, who has a trouble initially getting it, but ends up picking it up. And now we have a shot clock on for the Hens. Ortlieb spins. Now works it behind again. Gets it to Culinary. Culinary gets topside. Delaware going to have to try to put the ball on goal. There's a look inside. It's dropped. Ball still rolling around in Delaware's offensive end. And now it's picked up by Easel. Easel trying to get out of traffic. He cannot. And it's picked up by Villanova. Camizio. And we get a high check there from Trooper Ortlieb. This will be a free possession here for Villanova. Cuccinello. Gets behind to McNamara. Carroll with a long pass up top to Curran. For Carroll. Working on Tim Lyons. Draws the double team. John O'Connor, and he decides to take a wild shot. I don't know how Ficaro got that ball to Parker Farragut. But anyway, Farragut ended up with it. He had a change of possession, and thus the flag is enforced. So we will see the first man-up opportunity for either side, and it will be Villanova. Of the impressive stats that Villanova has put together, their man-up unit has not been a part of that. They are 2-for-18 on the season. Both of those goals have come from Jake Ficaro. It'll be a one-minute penalty. Cerrone. Whips it around. Now across. There's a skip pass. They wanted the shot, and it's in. Jake Ficaro gets his first goal of the afternoon on Man Up. He now has all three Man Up goals for the Wildcats this season. And Villanova has the first goal of the second quarter. They are now up 9-0. The penalty is released, so both teams will be at full strength. We just saw it again there. So it'll be Kroonquist and Herveda again. It actually looks like it's Joey Ficaro taking the faceoff. He loses the initial clamp, but the wing play is there. That is Curran getting the ground ball. And he gets it into Delaware into Villanova's offensive end, and they work it to X. Now the ball up top for Ficaro. Looks down low. Now up top, wide open. Shot, and it's in. Jake Ficaro with another one. Back to back. There for the reigning Lacrosse Magazine Player of the Week. And the Wildcats are now up 10-0. We see that little hesitation. Took one step further upfield and buried the righty sidearm shot. With 11 minutes and 8 seconds left in the second quarter, Villanova now up 10-0. And back at the faceoff X after a brief rest there. It was Paul Modesto. He wins it. I don't believe they have touched it in the box yet. Cuccinello goes to the far side, finds his man. That's Matt McIver. Now the first line of middies back on the field for Villanova. Clue with it. Spins back to his right. Looks down low. Cuccinello. Delaware's able to recover. Cuccinello goes again. Gets top side. Now moves it. McIver. Back to Cuccinello. Back to McIver again. He splits to his left. Draws the slide. Works it to X. Now we get a look up top. That pass is deflected by Carson Scott. Villanova is able to maintain possession. McNamara. Now Cuccinello with it. Looks inside. McNamara's there. Shot and a goal. McNamara slipped to the front of the crease. Nobody covered him. And he ducked it in for his third goal of the game. The first Wildcat of the many who have scored to reach the three-goal mark. Villanova now up 11-0. And it looked like, not sure exactly which defender it was, but they were so focused on the slide, neglected to turn their head and look for McNamara. That time Walsh wins the clamp, running towards Delaware's offensive end. It's picked up by Paul Major, and he's able to gain possession for the Hens. Fresina. First line of middies cycling onto the field for the Blue Hens. Just waiting for John O'Connor. Steve DeLargy now in. And we'll see if Delaware can get a good look at Cage. Fresina goes to the right side. Gets it up top to DeLargy. Now over to the near side. That's Will Hirschman. He's going to take a dodge. Spins back right on the short stick midi. Major with some room. Spins back right, guarded tightly by John Madursky. Romagnoli gets it behind. Major going to attack again. Gets a screen from Romagnoli to his right. Now gets it up top to DeLargy. Looks like Hirschman's going to want to take a dodge down the right side. He does. Spins back in. Has some room. Goes back right. Now he's going to take a shot. That one's deflected. The slide came from Curtis Naslonsky, the junior from Randolph, New Jersey. But the backup was there. Romagnoli gets top side. Spins back in. Takes a shot. Pings the top right corner. Beautiful shot there from the redshirt freshman. Six goals against VMI. And he finally puts Delaware on the board here this afternoon with an absolute snipe into the top right corner. So we'll take another look at it. His back was completely to the goal. That's some great field awareness. Delaware still in quite a bit of a hole, down 11-1, but certainly a bright spot there for the Hens. Maybe the spark they need. Now Delaware electing to put a pole on the faceoff. They had three poles on the faceoff, something that I personally have never seen. And now they'll have to reset. McNamara. Oh, and we get a check in the back there from Tim Lyons on McNamara. That'll be a flag. And the ball's moved to X. Cuccinello looking to feed. Gets top side. Ball goes up to Fracaro. It's another free possession. Look down low. Shot! Bouncer, and it's in. There from Curran. The flag will be wiped off. Curran bounces it past Farragan. And we'll see if it's an unnecessary roughness call or a slash. And it looks like it was unnecessary roughness there on Lyons. If it was a slash, it would have been wiped off with the goal. Looks like the penalty will stand. And Nova will have a man-up face-off. It was a slashing penalty, but they didn't wipe it off with the goal. But anyway, it's still a man-up face-off for Villanova. Walsh, this would be a huge face-off win for him. Ball still rolling around. And Palmadesso able to come up with it. Fast break opportunity, Palmadesso. Gets into the middle of the field, and now Villanova will have 40 seconds to get their man-up unit on the field. For Carroll, wide open. Going to take a rip. That one goes over the cage. Delaware having a tough time communicating this afternoon. And now John O'Connor has to run in. He's able to get a check on Cerrone before he's able to get the shot off. But now the ball goes inside to Joey Fracaro. And he goes low to low. Beats Parker Farragan. And it's another man-up goal for Villanova. They are now up 13-1.
Assisted by number 29, Sean Cerrone.
Joey Fracaro's first goal of the afternoon. And he now has two on the season. And just some mind-blowing stats here on this side. 32 shots for Villanova, 3 for Delaware. They've also been winning the ground ball battle 19-6. Villanova has yet to turn the ball over. Now Delaware has won the face-off, and they clear it. Tim Lyons is hung up. Let's try to get to Paul Major. Villanova did a nice job locking off their attackers and forcing Tim Lyons to try to get around them individually, and that did not work out too well for Delaware. 6 minutes and 30 seconds remaining in the half. Villanova is up by 12. There's a look inside. A shot goes just wide from Devin McNamara. Backup is there for Nova. Cuccinello working on Tim Lyons. Here's to the near side. That's McIver. Now Joey Fracaro. Goes to his right, draws the slide, still within his stick. Keeps moving, looks up top, finds his brother. And now Jake Fracaro will settle it down on the far wing. Looks to dodge on Connor Lally. Spins back. Fracaro looks inside to his brother, shot, and it's in! Joey Fracaro with his second goal of the game, fed by his brother. The Fracaro brothers now have a combined 8 points in the first half of this one. And now it'll be Kroonquist and Herveda back to take the face. Herveda tries to scoop it up one-handed. And now Matt Ulbrich is able to put it his way. Tries to spin out of a double team. Loses it on the sideline. It goes out of bounds. Villanova will get the ball back. Curran. touches it into the box. And they're going to actually say, I don't believe he ever touched it into the box. Now it's in. Cuccinello looks down low. Inside shot saved by Parker Farragan. Tries to start the fast break. Gets it to John O'Connor. Delaware will have a 4-on-3. But Paul Major shot. And that one goes barred down. Into the cage. Paul Major with an absolute rip there on the fast break. Executed well. Major's 8th goal of the season. And both goals for Delaware have been spectacular. But it's just been 12 less than Villanova. Let's take another look at it. Bar Deasy for Paul Major. So Delaware has put 2 shots on goal, and both of them have gone in. Still 5 minutes left in the half. Delaware down by 12. Herveda and Palmadesso back at the faceoff X. Palmadesso scoops that one out, and he will pick up the ground ball. Here's Willis bringing it up the field. The near side, Villanova able to get into their offensive half. And that one is dispossessed. Now going the other way, Elijah Conti. It's another man-up opportunity. Major, far side. Isel with a shot, and it's in! Joe Isel comes flying downhill out of the box, catches it lefty, and snipes it. Back-to-back goals for the Hens. It is now 14-3, Easel's 2nd goal of the season. Take another look at it here. Major, good field vision. Finds his fellow attacker coming downfield, and from 9 yards. Easel with the rip. It is now 14-3 Delaware. 14-3 Villanova, excuse me. For Major, that is his team-leading 6th assist of the season. Herveda wins that one. Gets him to John O'Connor. O'Connor avoids the wrap check. Inside, shot and a goal! John O'Connor avoids some vicious checks from behind, moves it to his right hand and buries it. 3 straight goals now for the Hens. O'Connor elevates his stick and then drops it lower left past Willis, who has faced 4 shots. He saved none. And now we will get a timeout from Villanova. So a little bit of life here from the Hens. And as both teams talk it over in their huddles, we will step aside. 4 minutes and 10 seconds left in the half when we return here at Hens All Access. Thank you. Now we are back at the face-off X. It will be Palmadesso and Herveda. Villanova has won 10 faceoffs. Delaware has won 9. But when Palmadesso has been at the X, it's been very much so Villanova, but not this time. Herveda comes up with a ground ball. He's getting checked from behind. Has to sprint out of it. Finally, he's able to get it up to Easel. Easel sprinting in, touches it into the box. And he leaves it back for Steve DeLargy. DeLargy looks inside. Easel gets hung up. Could not get the shot off. There were three Nova long pulls in there, and they immediately checked Easel's hands. And now the Blue Hens collapse into their defense. That one's checked out from behind. That one's scooped ahead. Ulbrich picks it up. He will run it into the offensive end. That is only the second turnover for Villanova this game. Major gets it to Easel, who can't quite haul it in. Very similar to the goal Easel scored just a few minutes prior, but that time he couldn't bring in the Paul Major pass, and Villanova again on the offensive end. That one checked out of the stick, but Camizio is able to pick it up. Now Curran has it. Jake Ficarro gets to John Clue. Clue with his right hand shot. That one saved by Parker Farragan. And the captain, senior from Lothian, Maryland, so quick. Ball goes behind. Cuccinello spins inside, takes a shot. That one saved. Goes off the head of Parker Farragan. This is a very different Delaware team here in the past few minutes than we saw in the beginning of this game. Major goes to his right, gets a screen from O'Connor, takes the shot. That one goes off the leg of the defender and goes out of play. Villanova closest to the ball when it went out of bounds. Went off the shin of Fernando Delgado. That's got to hurt. And a check up around the head from Romagnoli. John Clue somehow able to avoid losing the ball. Now Villanova touches it into the box. 1 minute and 20 seconds remaining in the half. Delaware scored the last three goals. There's a look inside. Shot! Not anymore. Matt McIver puts in another. He's got two. Taking a look at it here. Good feed inside. And that penalty will be enforced. Andrew Romagnoli with a 2 minute non-releasable hit to the head penalty. Which it was a tough check, but John Clue, as we mentioned, only standing at 5'4", and when he was crouched down, kind of hard to hit him anywhere else, but still a good call by the officials. Hits above the head have been hits to the head have been watched very closely the past few years, as they should. So a 2 minute non-releasable penalty. Delaware will be manned down for the remainder of the half and the start of the second half. There's a push from behind from Palmadesso. So Delaware will have the ball manned down. Major, I may have spoken too soon, unable to keep that ball from going out of bounds. So now Nova has it back, man up. One bounce into the stick of Cerrone. Villanova man-up unit on the field. There's Ficarro. Going to take a rip, and that one finds the right side of the goal. as have many other Villanova shots. Vaquero now has a hat trick to join McNamara. And it is now 16-4 Villanova with 47.2 seconds remaining in the first half. The penalty still in effect. Villanova now with more men up goals in this game than they have had in their entire season. Herveda tries to scoop it out, but Palmadesso is able to win the clamp and get it back to his wingman. Now inside, Curran. Vaquero now with it with 30 seconds remaining. Villanova still waiting for one more attacker to come in. Curran. Ball works behind. Vaquero has it again. Sidearm shot. That one misses. Villanova with the backup. 20.3 seconds left in the half. McNamara at X. Now with 10 seconds left in the half. Villanova still man up. It looks like McNamara will be comfortable going into half. Villanova will start the second half man up. And it looks like, feels like they played the first half man up. They go up into the locker room 16-4 over the University of Delaware Fighting Blue Hens. Seven players have scored for Villanova. All of them have multiple goals. McIver with two. Seibel with two. Joey Ficarro with two. Cuccinello with two goals and an assist. Curran, two goals and an assist. McNamara with three goals, two assists, and Ficarro, Jake Ficarro with three goals as well. So certainly plenty to talk about for the Blue Hens in the locker room and for Villanova. And for Villanova, just kind of keep doing what you're doing. They've done a great job moving the ball offensively, and their shots have been stellar. They've taken 40 shots. That kind of surprised me when I just looked down on it. 21 of them have been on goal, and they've made 16 of them. They scored 8 goals in the first quarter, 8 goals in the second. Delaware managed 4 goals in the second quarter, including a 3-goal run in about a 2-minute stretch where it looked like they had some life in them. And then Villanova came out, went man up, and ended any sort of life that was permeating through the stands and through the sideline here for Delaware. We have 9 minutes and 20 seconds to go before the second half. And we were going to step aside until the buzzer sounds. We'll be right back with the start of the second half here on Hens All Access.
Visit BlueHens.com for details and to reserve a group outing today.
The University of Delaware is currently leading 3-0 in the bottom of the seventh. The top of the seventh. Thank you.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Hens All Access's coverage of University of Delaware men's lacrosse. I'm Kyle Coulter here with you at University of Delaware Stadium, where it was a tough first 30 minutes, to say the least, for the Blue Hens. They find themselves down 16-4 to the Villanova Wildcats, the 14th-ranked Villanova Wildcats here on this Saturday afternoon. For the Hens, Paul Major, Andrew Remagnoli, and Joe Esel all have a goal apiece. Also, John O'Connor with a goal and an assist. Paul Major with an assist as well. On the other side, it's been pretty much a who's who over there. Joey and Jake Ficaro with a combined 9 points. McNamara with 3 goals, 3 assists. Karan with 2 goals, 1 assist. Cuccinello with 2 goals and an assist. Cerrone with 2 assists. Seibel with 2 goals. McIver with 2 goals. And to top it all off, Villanova will start the second half with the ball man up, courtesy of a two-minute non-releasable penalty by Andrew Remagnoli to end the first half. Joey Ficaro moves it up top. Back to Cerrone, look down low. McNamara, Blue Hens recover. That ball is tipped. Now back up top to Cerrone. One more to Joey Ficaro. He avoids one check, takes a shot. It's saved by Farragan. Now Conti has it. It'll be a 5-on-4 going the other way. Conti to his right. Decides instead to pull it out and wait for the penalty to be up, and now it is. Stella will get their first line of middies onto the field. DeLargy up top to DeSanzo. Now Major behind. Andrew Remagnoli has a short stick. They like the matchup. It is Jake Ficaro. Remagnoli spins. Shot. That one goes wide, out of play. They're going to call a slash on Jake Ficaro. So we will see the Delaware man-up unit for the first time this afternoon. They, much like the Villanova man-up unit, have not had much success this season. They've only scored 2 goals on 14 opportunities. But we'll see if they can change that here and get the scoring start in their favor for the second half. Looks like they'll start in a 1-3-2. You see Mike Hanlon check in, as well as Dean DeSimone. Remagnoli. DeSimone with it now. DeSimone steps down. Now moves it. That's Hirschman. Remagnoli has it again. Now Esel. DeSimone. Fakes the pass. Now goes to Hirschman. Gets it back up to DeSimone. Looks down low. That's the skip they were looking for, but it was read beautifully by Owen Hughes, who picks it off and gets it back to Dan Willis, who will look to clear for the Cats. Cerrone uses his speed, splits 2 defenders. Still 10 seconds left on the penalty. Delaware electing not to double team. Curran dodges to his right. The penalty is released, so both teams at full strength. And Villanova with the ball. McNamara gets it up top. There's Cerrone working on John O'Connor. Splits to his left. Now leaves it back for Curran. Curran with some room. 5 yards away. Moves it down low. Cuccinello looks inside. Now goes to the near side for McNamara. Ficaro. Cuccinello with it again. Gets topside, draws the slide, now moves it. There's the look, there's the shot, and it's missed wide from number 9, Johnny Galloway, the senior from Middletown, Maryland. McNamara gets topside, check, dislodged there by John O'Connor. Beautiful defense there from the short stick midi. Not easy to do, guarding an attackman from behind. But he did so beautifully there, but a turnover from Connor Lally was being forced towards the near sideline, tried to sidearm a pass to Easel. Now Villanova with it again. Cuccinello. Gets it over to the right side. There's McIver. He's going to take a dodge. Goes to the middle of the field. Has some room. Decides to move it for Caro. Cross field. For Caro. Has a screen to his right. Doesn't use it. Draws the double team. Now moves it. Curran. Far side for McIver. Now gets it to X with Cuccinello. There's the look. There's the step-down shot. The bouncer goes wide. Villanova with the backup again. There's a look down low. Cuccinello. We get a foul and a goal to add to it. McNamara gets above goal line. Extended. Goes between the legs of Farragan. And there will be a penalty to boot. Cuccinello with the assist. And they will wipe off the penalty. So now 17-4 Villanova. McNamara with his team-leading fourth goal of the afternoon. He now has 10 goals on the season. He also has 3 assists. Now with 7 on the season as well. Herveda wins that faceoff but loses it after the check from Palmadesso. Now Palmadesso gets it. It'll be a fast break. Palmadesso wants the goal and he's got it. He's been doing it from the faceoff X and he wanted to put the ball in the back of the net and he does so. Take another look at it here. He had an attackman to his left, but decided to take it all the way. And from 11 yards out, rips it and goes far side of the cage. That is his first goal of the season. He gets a big hug from his teammates. He is now the 8th Wildcat to score on the afternoon. And he'll get a break, so Joey Ficaro and Herveda will take the face-off. Herveda wins it, flips it to himself. And now he'll work to get it in Delaware's offensive end. Roll Magnoli gets to Major, who touches it in. Major to his left. Ulbrich gets to DeLarge, sets a screen. DeLarge's in. DeLarge shot. DeLarge goal. Between the legs of Dan Willis. Steve DeLarge gets his first goal of the afternoon. That is his 4th goal of the season. Take another look at it here. Just sheer willpower. Had 2 long sticks in his way, but enough strength to muscle through. And puts it in. Is now 18-5 Villanova. Back to the faceoff X. And Palmadesso jumps that one, so John O'Connor will run and pick up the ground ball. He gets it up to Easel. Now Delaware will cycle through. Romagnoli fakes the pass. Now goes back to his right-hand guard tightly by Danny Sweeney. Now the ball goes to X. There's Major to his left. Gets topside. Now rolls back. DeLarge muscling his way through. Shot. Bouncer goes just wide. Lowered his shoulder. Created just enough separation. But could not bury the shot. Here's Romagnoli from X. Splits to his right, where another defender is lurking. Now gets it up top to DeSanzo. Frasina has the short stick. He's going to take a dodge. The slide is waiting for him. Spins back to his right. Good defense there from the short stick midi, Jack Coran. Major. Looks inside. DeLargy runs through one check, takes a shot. The ball flies out of his stick, but we get a broken stick. And it'll be an illegal procedure penalty there against number 28, Fernando Delgado. Not only did his twig snap, but then he also gets the penalty on top of it. It'll be 30 seconds. Man up for Delaware. So we'll get another look at Delaware's man-up unit, who were unsuccessful in their first go-around. They start in a 1-4-1 here. Romagnoli, DeSanzo, DeSimone. Hirschman gets it across to DeSimone. 15 seconds left in the penalty. Esel, DeSimone takes a rip and got it. Stick side high past Willis. And it is now 18-6. Dean DeSimone with his first goal of the season and only his second game played. So it's now 18-6, 8 minutes and 30 seconds remaining in the third quarter. We're back at the faceoff X. It'll be Pomodesso and Herveda. Herveda won the clamp, pokes it out his way. Now gooses it back, and it's picked up by Haynes. Dropped, and he picks it up again, and now puts it forward. Herveda possibly could have had a four-on-three opportunity there, but decides to pull it out and wait for Delaware's offense to set up. Esel gets to Major. Major's in. Cross-field pass. Ulbrich shot and a goal! Matt Ulbrich with a rip. His first goal of the season, and I gotta say, I'm liking the classic rock music choices here for University of Delaware after they're scoring a goal. Let's take another look at it. Major beat his man. Ulbrich saw it, came flying downhill, and from 7 yards out, rifles a shot past Dan Willis. It's now 18-7. Now we're back at the faceoff X. Herveda has done a nice job against Pomodesso, but this time Pomodesso wins the clamp. Ball still loose. Pomodesso picks it up. Avoids the mighty check from Austin Haynes. And Villanova back on offense. Ficarro. First line of middies on the field for Villanova. And a flag down. Elijah Conti's check got Cerrone up around the face mask. Clue takes a shot, low angle. And now a big check there from Carson Scott pushes Clue out of bounds. Change in possession now. And after the flag, that'll give Villanova a man-up opportunity. It was Conti, so Delaware will be man down for 1 minute. Villanova is 3-for-3 on their man-up opportunities. Starting a 2-3-1 for Carroll up top. Look inside. There is the look. And Joey Ficarro buries it. One of the defenders for Delaware fell. I believe it might have been John O'Connor. And that allowed Joey Ficarro to get open. And now he joins his brother as both Ficarro brothers have a hat trick. Penalty is wiped off. It is now 19-7. Villanova. And we are just over midway through the third quarter. Back to the faceoff, X. Herveda tries to pull it, but Palmadeso had the clamp. Ball still loose middle of the field. Palmadeso going for the ground ball. Play on is called, and Villanova will get the ball after a loose ball push against Delaware. The Delaware coaching staff enraged at the call. Now Joey Vaccaro with some speed. He falls. Guarded by Matt Ulbrich. Now Delaware's got to recover. There's the look up top. Step down for Carroll with a rip, and that misses the cage. McNamara was there with the backup. Sir Curran. McNamara backside. Quick shot, but easily handled there by Parker Farragan. Now a quick outlet pass was knocked down. Ulbrich's able to pick it up, or not so. Took that one for granted, but he misplayed it. Now the ball rolls back in the middle of the field for Carroll. Picks up the ground ball. Touches it into the box. Loses it. And now Haynes, who caused the turnover, comes up with it. He's going into the offensive end. Gets it into Esel. Now back behind. Major. Or excuse me, that's Ron McNally. Gets topside. Spins. Takes the shot. That one's no good. Esel is there with the backup, and that allows Delaware's first line of offensive middies to get back on the field with 4 minutes and 53 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Esel. Connor Fresina now with it. Guarded by Joey Vaccaro. Splits to his left. Now moves it. DeSanzo. Righty. Shot and a goal. Nick DeSanzo keeps the stick in his right hand, gets the angle, gets closer to the cage, and buries it in the top right. And Delaware, now with 8 goals, their third best scoring output of the season. And if it wasn't for that first quarter, this would still be a game. Villanova outscored Delaware 8-0 in the first 15 minutes, then 8-4 in the second. But here in the third quarter, Delaware's actually outscored Villanova 4-3. Herveda wins another faceoff. The freshman from Philly getting it done at the X against statistically the second best faceoff man in the country. Villanova overall, the top faceoff team in the nation. DeLargy has it now. Free possession for Delaware as the flags fly. The flag coming against Villanova after a check against Connor Fresina. Paul Major leaves it back. Fresina fakes the pass. Now gets it over to Major. Major. Now up to DeLargy. He's going to take a dodge. Crossfield pass, beautiful find, DeSanzo with a shot, and the first save of the game made by Dan Willis. DeLargy is fired up. It was a great look over to DeSanzo, who couldn't quite finish. But Willis, who had faced, prior to that shot, had faced 8 shots on goal, had not been able to stop a single one, finally makes a save. And now we'll get another look at Delaware's man-up unit. 1 of 2 on the afternoon. DeSimone. Ron McNally now with it. Delaware in the 1-4-1. Now they rotate out of it. DeSimone. Looks inside. There's a rip. That one goes just left from Will Hirschman. Still 39 seconds left in the penalty. Delaware with some time. Yo, Romagnoli with it. Paul Major being locked off, so they're pretty much playing 5-on-4. Cross field, Hirschman. Now to DeSimone. Fakes the pass, looks inside. Tough pass. And it was unable to be handled there, but Delaware still with it with 18 seconds left in the penalty. DeSimone. Hirschman. Back to DeSimone. 9 in the penalty now. Paul Major still being locked off. Penalty about to release, and it is. Esel. That one checked way out of Esel's stick, rolling towards the end line. Scooped up by Romagnoli. The keeper's out of the cage. DeSimone rolls back to his right. Fakes the pass again. He's been favoring that move. Major with a shorty. Guarding him is Nick Tortoriello, the junior from Stockton, New Jersey. Tortoriello was locking him off during the man-up opportunity. DeSimone with another rip, and he got it. Dean DeSimone gets above goal line, extended, turns, and fires for his second goal of the afternoon. It is now 19-9 Villanova. We'll take another look at it here. He draws the slide, and even as his upper body is fading away from the goal, his arm strength, very impressive, and he rockets it into the top right corner. Now we're back to the faceoff X. The scrum in the middle. Paul Modesto and Haynes running for it. Ball's up. No play on has been called. John O'Connor scoops it up with one hand and gets it over to Paul Major. Major touches it in. And we do have a new keeper in the cage for the Wildcats. We'll get you his name in just a minute once play stops. There's the shot. That one goes just wide. The backup is there. It is number 31, Nick Pressler, the freshman from Medford, New Jersey. He's listed as a defenseman. It is number 31 in the cage. Oh, excuse me. I'm looking at the wrong side. Nick Testa, the freshman from Rexford, New York. Looking at Delaware's side of the scorecard. It's been a long day. Nick Testa in the cage for Villanova. Now Steve DeLargy has it behind with under 2 minutes to go in the third quarter. Esel has a short stick guarding him. I think Delaware might take advantage of that. Fresina gets it up to DeSanzo. DeSanzo to his right. Rolls back. DeLargy with a shot. That one's saved. Nick Testa stands tall. Knocks down the shot. And now Villanova has it on the other side. Feels like it's been a while since they've been on offense. Jake Ficarro, guarded by Connor Lally. Comes off a screen, takes a rip. That one misses. One minute left in the third quarter, which is actually, if you look at the score, has been won by Delaware. Villanova with it now, 45 seconds. That is Joey Ficarro, guarded by Elijah Conti behind the cage. Joey Ficarro, little dummy dodge and then retreats. Looks like he will run down the clock. Now he attacks. Conti falls. Ficarro gets double teamed. A hit up high, the ref reaching for his flag, and he throws it. Another penalty on Elijah Conti. Joey Ficarro the recipient of the hit. And we'll see exactly what the penalty is. With 9.8 seconds left, looks like in all likelihood, Villanova will start the fourth, will run out the clock and start the fourth quarter man up. It'll be a cross check on Elijah Conti. It looks like Danny Seibel will hold the ball for the final seconds of the third quarter. And Villanova will start the final 15 minutes man up for another 51 seconds. But, you know, if you looked at the stats from the first quarter and the stats from the third quarter, you would think these were two entirely different games. In the first quarter alone, Villanova outshot Delaware 25-1. But then there in the second, then there in the third quarter, Delaware actually outshot Villanova 13 to 10. They also outscored the Wildcats 5-3. With Dean DeSimone with two, Ulbrich now has one. Paul Major with a goal and two assists. DeSanzo got on the board, and also and as well did Steve DeLargy. Parker Farragut has given up 19 goals, but he's also made eight saves. Jay Curveda has done an outstanding job from the faceoff X. He's taken 17 faceoffs. He's won 11. So 10 goals may be a bit insurmountable here in the final 15 minutes, but certainly some positives to take away from the last two quarters for the Blue Hens. It looks like Parker Farragut will come back out for the fourth quarter. And actually, he's going into the cage to retrieve his water bottle. So looks like we might get a new keeper in for the Hens. But we mentioned before the game started that faceoffs are going to be a huge factor in this game. They haven't really turned out that way, but Delaware has won 17 of 30 faceoffs against the top, percentage-wise, the top faceoff team in the country. So certainly something for them to build on and look positively at. And Farragut will stay in the game. Delaware starting the fourth quarter as they did the third quarter, man down. And we are underway here in the fourth quarter. Villanova up by 10, and personnel-wise up by 1. Seibel. He'll run it up top. Now Seibel, look to step down. He gets it again. Jake Ficarro fakes the pass, now does pass it. Now down low, the ball is loose. Scooped up there by Carson Scott. So Delaware man down. Does the job initially. Now they still have to clear it. John O'Connor sprinting full speed, but he's dispossessed there from behind by Jack Curran. Great hustle from the captain. Penalty releases in 4 seconds. Jake Ficarro with a rip into the top left corner. It'll still go down as a man-up goal. He now has 4 on the day. Still shy of his season average, however. Take another look at it. There. Switches his stick down to a lower angle and rockets it past Parker Farragut. Villanova now with 20 goals. That's a season high for them. It'll be Palmadesso and Herveda back at the faceoff X. Ulbrich and Curtis Naslonski on the near side. Herveda pushes it out to himself, now gooses it back, trying to pick up the ground ball. It's finally picked up by Villanova. and then put into Villanova's offensive end. It's a 3-on-2. There's the look down low. The shot saved by Parker Farragut. It's stuck in between his legs. And Carson Scott able to help him out there. And that pass low. Trying to find Phil Pena. But it bounces at the feet of number 5. And after a nice save, Delaware now back on defense. They're now 6 of 9 on the clears for the afternoon. Cuccinello. Jake Ficarro. Here's McIver with the dodge. Jake Ficarro with another rip. That one goes off the crossbar. Jake Ficarro is taking 15 shots this afternoon. Here's Joey Ficarro. Cuccinello. McIver gets a screen, uses it. Gets bumped out by Phil Pena. Now the ball goes behind. McNamara. There's a rip from Seibel, but Parker Farragut up to the task. He makes another save. He now has 11 this afternoon. Ulbrich. Esel spins off it, and we get a illegal procedure there. Might have been an offsides call there against Delaware, or it seems like the referee is talking to the sideline. Now a flag is down. It'll be against the Delaware bench. Was watching the ref the whole time on the far side. Coach Shills and the Delaware coaching staff are having some words with the referee, and he immediately and emphatically threw the flag. So after the save from Farragut there on the dodge from Ficarro, the Villanova will be man up once again. It'll be a 1 minute penalty. Joe Esel will serve. And that is the 6th penalty on the University of Delaware for a combined 420 seconds. There's a look inside. Shot saved by Farragut. Ball still bouncing around. Another shot, and that one goes wide. Farragut thought he might have been there for the backup, but Villanova a step quicker. Seibel gets it up top. There's the look down low. McNamara brings it up top. Now a long pass goes over the head of Seibel. And Haynes falls as he tries to go pick up the ground ball. Crossfield look. Now right back. Shot and a goal right at the doorstep. And they're going to say he was in the crease, so no goal. Timmy Hardy, the freshman from Pasadena, Maryland, trying to get in the scoring column. Now he dumps it off to John. Haynes jumps it off to John O'Connor. O'Connor to Major. Major to Esel coming. DeLargy coming downhill. DeLargy threw his body around but lost the ball. Now he gets it back. 11 minutes remaining in regulation. Delaware down by 11. Fresina with the dodge. Draws the slide. Now DeSanzo back on the field. And Delaware will get their entire first line back on. The penalty is released. Esel. Short stick guarding him from behind. Spins to his left. Gets top side, looks to the crease. Major with a shot and a goal. Beautiful look there by Joe Esel. Great finish from Paul Major. Delaware now with 10 goals. They are still doubled up by Villanova, 20-10. But a great look Taking a look at it here, Major. Just as soon as the ball touched his stick, jackknifed it down in the bottom left corner. Major now with 2 goals, 2 assists. Esel with a goal and 2 assists. Palmadesso. Delaware wins another faceoff. Ulbrich tries to get it over Cuccinello, but Cuccinello skies into the air and knocks that pass out of midair. Jake Vaccaro with a rip and a goal. He's just having fun at this point. Gave him a little bit of room, and he now has 5 on the afternoon on 18 shots. Taking a look at it here, how does nobody come out and try to defend? Just kind of a lax one-handed stick thrown in front of Ficaro's shot. That's not going to stop it. So now 21 goals for Villanova. Delaware once again down by 11 with just over 10 minutes to go. And now we're going to get a penalty, a flag thrown. I believe it's going to be on Delaware as Austin Haynes is walking towards the bench. We'll wait to hear the official word from the sideline, but Delaware's man down unit looks like they might be coming onto the field. So it will be a penalty on each side, actually, both for unsportsmanlike conduct. The first one on Devin McNamara and the one for Delaware on Austin Haynes. Both unsportsmanlike conduct, both one-minute penalties, so it will be a 5-on-5. The faceoff still needs to be taken, so the far wing is left vacant. Villanova with 4 poles on the field. Delaware only with 3. So the ball goes towards the side where Haynes would have been. And now Delaware quickly gets Herveda off and a pole onto the field. So it's a 5-on-5 for 45 more seconds. Cuccinello from X. Here's Cerrone from up top. He dodges, draws the slide, moves it down low. Cuccinello. Defender switch. He rolls inside. Nowhere to go. Coma slide comes. Delaware recovers. 17 seconds left on the penalty. Cerrone. Getting hounded by Matt Ulbrich. Now gets it up top. 5 on the penalty. Cuccinello. Rolls back to his right, looking back door. There it is, the shot and the goal. It was a beautiful find from Cuccinello, a great curl from number 3, Harry Delaferra, the senior from Locust Valley, New York. He puts it in. He gets on the scoring. Gets in on the scoring, I should say. We'll take another look at it here. The adjacent slide was ready to go, which he needed to be, but his man, Delaferra, was lost backside. So now 22 goals for Villanova. They're up 12, 9 minutes and 2 seconds remaining in regulation. Herveda. That time it was Kroonquist on the face. Face-off, a foul against Villanova. And Delaware gets the ball. Both teams back at full strength. Delaware will wait for the first line of middies to get back on the field. for Cena. DeSanzo coming out of the box. Hard dodge to his right. Looks for the rollback. It's not there. Gets it to Romaglia. Fresina to his right. Gets top side. Looks like he wanted to turn and fire. Now DeLargy with it. Garnering the attention of the long stick midi. Now DeSanzo from up top. Splits to his right. Nice move. Gets inside. Works it down low. Good look. Christina, but right there. Picking it out of midair was Testa. Good job there by the freshman. Because that would have been a surefire Connor Fresina goal on the backside. Now we see some fresh faces on the field for the Wildcats. Number 17, Nick Ellis, the sophomore from West Deptford, New York, in the game. Also number 22, Andrew Gallahue, the freshman from Hampton, New Hampshire. Gallahue with it. Moves it over to Timmy Hardy. Hardy on the dodge. Works it back to X. Here's Danny O'Connell. Gets it up top. Now up to Ellis. Ellis dodges to his right. Draws the slide and moves it. O'Connell looks up top. There's a shot and a goal from number 9, Johnny Galloway. The assist from O'Connell. Galloway, that is his second assist of the season. And for Danny O'Connell, that is his first point of the season with that assist. Villanova now with 23 goals. Now once again, back to the faceoff X. That one is won by Kroonquist. Herveda with a hard check. Dislodges the ball. Villanova with it. John O'Connor. Getting a shove on Nick Ellis. Ellis still with it. Trying to get by Haynes. And we get a ward there against Ellis. Quick restart for the Hens. Ulbrich corrals in. It'll be a fast break. Ulbrich to Major. Major shot, and it's in. Paul Major with the hat trick. Delaware forced the turnover and converts. And we just heard that University of Delaware baseball team taking down UMass Lowell 4-2, and UMass Lowell's only two runs coming in the top of the ninth. So an impressive day there from the Hens. Now 23-11, 34 combined goals in this game. My goodness. All of Delaware's coming after the first quarter after they were shut out in the first 15 minutes. Good fight there from the Hens getting that face-off win. Romagnoli. Guarded by Owen Hughes. Goes back to his right. Looks to get topside. Takes a shot. That one's deflected and goes into the stick of Testa, who tries to start the fast break. Outlet pass up to number 8, Kevin Kelly. And there's Ryan Russell, the freshman from Denver, Colorado, with it. The ball goes behind. De La Fera. Back to O'Connell. Ellis Russell with it again. Elijah Conti on defense. De La Fera. Excuse me. Gets to X. Now leaves it off for O'Connell. There's the look inside. And some contact in the crease. They're going to say it was a push on Delaware. So Villanova will maintain possession with under 5 minutes to go in regulation. Russell. To his left. Here's O'Connell from X. Goes back to his right. Looks in. Finds. Shot. That one misses. It was a low angle for Johnny Galloway. As it goes out of bounds on the sideline. Great hustle from Connor Lally to win that ball for the Hens. And now we will get a timeout by Villanova with 4 minutes and 34 seconds. Remaining in regulation, we will step aside because I need a bit of a breather after 34 goals. But we'll be right back with the conclusion of this one here on Hens All Access. Don't go anywhere.
Fans, as a reminder, we'd like you to please stick around at the conclusion of today's game for the presentation of the Boat Roberts Game MVP Award.
Cowgirls are back with you here at University of Delaware Stadium. 4 minutes, 30 seconds remaining in regulation. Matt Ulbrich with it on the near side for the Hens. Trying to split two defenders and clear the ball. Gets it to Carson Scott. Scott tries to go cross-field pass, but that one is picked off by O'Connell. And Villanova back on offense. J.P. Campbell flips it back. It's number 22, Andrew Gallahue. Gallahue gets it up top. Works around to the far side. It's number 36, Max Durham. Sophomore from Doylestown, Pennsylvania. Now you get a dodge. Roll back to the right from Gallahue. Good defense from Phil Pena. De La Fera gets it up. There's Durham. Rolls back to his left. Wrap check there from John O'Connor. Durham loses the ball, but is able to pick it back up. O'Connell. Goes back to his right. Goes behind the cage. De La Fera trying to get into some kind of shooting position, but can't. O'Connell looks inside. That one's knocked down, picked off by Parker Farragan. Delaware looked to clear. Long outlet pass to Ulbrich. Catches it on the hop. And whereas we've seen a lot of fresh faces for Nova, not so for Delaware. We've pretty much stuck with the same midi line. We do see 19, Alex Martinelli, into the game. There's a rip from up top for Connor Fresina. He gets his first goal of the afternoon, now turned almost turned evening. Take another look at it. He splits to his right, gets enough room, and from 15 out, buries it. Good shot there from the senior. And Delaware now has scored the second most goals they have all season. They have also conceded more goals than they've given up in the past three games combined. Herveda wins the faceoff, trying to start a break for the Hens. Martinelli with a rip. That one goes wide of the cage. But there with the backup is number 36, Campbell Parker. Chris Collinari with it. Two minutes remaining in regulation. Collinari splits to his right, gets a screen, looks, shot and a goal. Beautiful offense. Mike Hanlon with the G. And that was about as pretty an offensive set as we've seen from the Hens. Take another look at it here. Collinari gets the screen to his right, uses it, looks back. Hanlon curls, separates from his defender, and then puts a rocket by Testa on the far right side of the cage. It's now 23-13, 36 combined goals. Don't have the record books in front of me here, but that's got to be some kind of Delaware Stadium record for total goals in a game. There weren't even football games here in the fall that had this many points. A hold there against Villanova. And how about Jake Herveda? He's taken 25 faceoffs. He's won 16 of them. Olbrich is able to pull that one back in. Now Collinari with it from up top. Splits to his left, rolls back to his right, draws the slide. And now puts a bounce pass back to Dean DeSimone, who's got two goals on the afternoon for the Hens. Collinari dodges, looks inside. Finds his man, that was Hanlon, but it gets knocked down. Nick Ellis sprinting in to Delaware, to Villanova's half of the field. O'Connell avoids a check from Carson Scott, and he moves it up top to number 43, TJ Camizio, the defensive midi who's now getting some offensive runs here, it looks like. Camizio. Long pass backside to O'Connell. Ellis with it now. Ellis gets double teamed. Now the ball goes down low on a hop to De La Fera. 20 seconds to go. De La Fera will retreat into the corner. And now lofts it up to Brendan Black, the freshman from Princeton, New Jersey. And with 6 seconds to go, Ellis, or O'Connell rather, looks like he will hold it in the corner. And that will do it. The 14th-ranked Villanova Wildcats come into the University of Delaware and take down the Blue Hens by a score of 23-13. A season high in goals for the Wildcats. Second best offensive performance from the Hens. But after an 8-0 start to this game, it was a tough hole for Delaware to climb out of. They actually won the second half. They outscored Villanova 9-7. Take that with a little bit of grain of salt after Villanova subbed out some of its starters in the latter portion of the fourth quarter. But 61 shots for Villanova. That is incredible. 18 of them coming from Jake Fracaro. He had 5 goals, 3 assists. McNamara with 4 goals, 3 assists. Curran with 2 goals, 2 assists. Cuccinello with 2 goals and 4 assists. Cerrone did not score, but he had a hat trick of assists. Joey Fracaro with 3 goals and 1 dime. Seibel with 2 goals. McIver with 2 goals. Galloway, Palmadesso, Delaferra all with a goal. Now looking at Delaware side, Paul Major led the way with 3 goals, 2 assists. DeLarge with a goal. Roe Magnoli with a goal. DeSanzo with a goal. Isel with a goal and 2 assists. Fersina with a goal. DeSimone with 2. Hanlon, Ulbrich, and O'Connor all with a goal as well. So Villanova improves to 3-1. Delaware drops to 1-5. They now head on a 4-game road trip. They'll be back at home to open CAA play against Massachusetts on April 2nd. So that's the next time we will see the men's lacrosse team here on Hens All Access. Well, it was a very busy day here at University of Delaware Stadium. The women got the victory. The men, unfortunately, took the loss. But it was a fun day of lacrosse nonetheless. So glad you could all be a part of it and taking your time on this Saturday to watch some great lacrosse here on Hens All Access. Well, that'll do it for us. Until next time, I'm Kyle Coulter. Have a great day, everybody.